Hi, I'm Stefan, Senior Solutions Architect from AWS.
Hi, I'm Aurélien Capdecom, CTO at 20 Minutes, and this is my architecture.
Okay, Aurélien, thanks for bringing this architecture today. It looks super interesting. I see you using Bedrock and Comprehend, our AI and generative AI services. I'd like to learn how you're using this in your platform to help your customers.
Okay. At 20 Minutes, as you know, we are a French major news company.
Right.
We have a lot of traffic on our website and applications. This is why a few years ago we chose to go serverless, because we want scalability, availability, and cost optimization. And this is why today we use Bedrock, because it's it fits in our philosophy, technical philosophy.
Cool, that sounds interesting. So I see there are journalists working with your system. Maybe you walk us through the flow.
Okay, so Storm is our CMS. Mm-hmm. It's a single page application. Our journalist uses Storm to write content. By content, I mean article, live, slideshow, etc.
Got it.
Storm will call our API.
Yeah.
The name is Nova, like the star. It's a combination of API gateway and Lambda.
So it's all serverless. It's the APIs that back your content management system.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we store everything in DynamoDB, and we synchronize everything in OpenSearch, basically for search and statistics.
Got it. So the main content store is DynamoDB, and the rest is to enhance user experience, right? Cool. Now I see also there are a couple of Lambda functions here on the bottom and our generative AI services. So how did you integrate it in your CMS?
We have some use case. The first one is we need to summarize content. We want to add 3 bullet points at the beginning of every content. For achieve that goal, it's the same workflow, Storm, Nova. With EventBridge, Nova invoke the summarize content Lambda function, and that function will ask Amazon Bedrock.
Got it.
We choose Cloud 2.1. We will migrate to a newer version in the next few weeks. So this Lambda function asks Bedrock to summarize the content in 3 short sentences.
Got it. So I, as a journalist, I've written an article. Now I just click a button, and then generative AI summarizes the content for me.
You got it.
So it saves a lot of time, right?
Yes, it's hours per week.
Cool. That's awesome. So then I'm also curious to learn more, like what kind of prompt engineering did you do to make sure that it is really working that way?
It was a hard part of the job. We ask Claude to be neutral, to respect codes, to respect names. It was many iterations to get the right prompt.
Got it. But you solved it for your journalists, and now you save time. Mm. Now, what does rewrite article do?
You may know in the news publisher world, we use a news dispatch. Mm-hmm. So in France, we have an agency, AFP, Agence France Presse.
Got it.
And our journalists can find every dispatch in Storm.
Okay.
Before generative AI, when a journalist wanted to create a new article based on a dispatch, he had to copy and paste the content into a blank article and rewrite it. It was a long task, boring task.
Yeah.
Not the fun part of their job. Now, we added a new button, rewrite that content with AI. So it's the same workflow in Storm. You click on the button, Nova, and EventBridge will invoke Lambda function, write article. And we call Amazon Bedrock with basically the same prompt, but that time we don't want to summarize, we want Bedrock to rewrite the content.
Got it. And then you send it back to the journalist, and again, you save a lot of time for the journalist.
Yeah. It's important to note that the journalist will correct, validate the content before publishing.
Got it. I think it also needs to adhere with your tone and your language,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. Got it. And then last but not least, we have suggest tags. What is behind that?
It was our first AI use case. We need, for SEO purposes, to add tags on every content.
Yeah.
And links inside every content to match every content between them.
Makes it also easier for your customers to go through the articles.
It's easy for a reader to switch from an article to another and for a crawler to find every article. In that use case, it's the same workflow, but when you have written your article, you can focus on a field in Storm to add tags. And this is when we will call Nova, and Nova will invoke that Lambda, and that Lambda will ask Comprehend to extract entities from the content, and we will match those entities with our database in OpenSearch.
You have a common entities and tag database that you store in OpenSearch?
We have a tag database in OpenSearch.
Yeah.
And by tag, I mean it could be an event, a person, or an organization. So it often match with the entities that we get from Comprehend.
Got it. And then you make sure that all the entities and the tags that are being generated are in line with the tags that you want to use on your site.
Yes.
Got it. Okay, Oren, this is a super interesting architecture. Thank you for sharing this architecture with us today.
Thank you for inviting me today.